Hello there and welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you for sharing part of your day with us. And we always try to give you good information. And first of all, today we have Janice Butler. Now, Janice is the Executive Director of the Christian Learning Centers of Greenville County. And this is a marvelous opportunity for middle school and high school students. And I thank you, Janice,
thank
for
you,
coming.
Thank you, Peggy. Thank you so much.
So your purpose is to bring the love of God and Christian basic principles to students.
That's exactly right. And the reason for that, Peggy, is because there's a group of us, large group of us in Greenville County, we're so concerned right now. We know the answer lies with God, but we're very concerned about what's happening with our young people. As you know, recently there have been some states that have shootings in schools. There have been students who've been assaulted.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of young people who are practicing immorality, a lot of violence, a lot of apathy in school. And with our country going in a direction from God, we're so concerned about our Christian legacy in the future. And we know that right now is the time that we need to allow these young people to come to a place where we can equip them for what's down the road. They need to be in the Word of God, and they need as many opportunities as possible to be in the Word of God.
Now you give, here's the brochure, it's lovely, and you give each young person a Bible.
Right.
This is like non-denominational. You don't preach one particular sect of, you don't, you know, say Baptist or Presbyterian or whatever.
Right.
You just try to present the Lord.
That's exactly right. And I was talking about, you know, with the concern that we had to go before the Lord and ask the Lord what it was it that we can do. And a group of people came to our county about in 1996 and told us about a concept called Release Time Christian Education. And it hadn't started or anything like that. I went to that meeting because I just love to teach young people about the Word of God. And there were a lot of others there too. And so once we found out about Release Time Christian Education, a time during the school day that young people could leave school from a related arts class and go to another place near the school and have Bible. Because, you know, God's expelled from school. You can't talk about God in school. You can't, learn
you
about God.
You couldn't hold this on any school property, no matter how much room they had.
No, that's exactly
right. So you have to take the students to another place.
That's right. And as you know, well, we have our churches, and this program doesn't take the place of churches. This program gives people in churches a place to go out and share their faith. So we are able to teach the young people Bible because they need that. The Christian children who have a place to go to church and have families to teach them the Word of God, they need to be encouraged during their school day. They have a mission field. The schoolhouse is their mission field. Who's going to support them to reach that mission field? So we need to be there for the Christian students. And then there are the students who don't go to church anywhere.
They don't have the family support, or they don't have any knowledge through their family.
Right. And with everything that's going on in our society right now, all the different things that when I was young, everybody, even non-Christians, thought they were wrong. You know, this attack against marriage and things like that. Yeah. You know, the young people need to know the truth because the truth is what's going to set them free. And we need them to know the truth because in the future, we want to have a dynamic Christian legacy even in the future. And that's going to take place if we equip these young people. And when a door closes, like the door closed that wouldn't allow us to be able to do Bible classes during school, like it was when I was coming up, we had devotionals, we prayed, our textbooks.
We started our day with a salute to the flag and a prayer.
That's right.
And this was a public school. And they would pray before a football game.
And it didn't hurt us any, did it? It helped us.
I don't think it did. I think we did pretty well.
It helped us. But because of the loss, then, you know, things changed.
Yeah.
Well, God is not going to be outdone. You know, He wants us to suffer little children to come unto Him. And so He opened another door. He opened another door, and that door is Release Time Christian Education. Now we can follow the law. The parents who want Bible classes or religious activities for their young people while they're in school, now they have Release Time Christian Education.
Now a parent has to sign off on this.
Exactly.
And exactly. So, and this is for middle or?
We serve middle and high school students.
All over Greenville County.
All over Greenville County.
And are there other areas that have similar things?
All over the nation.
All right. Okay. So young we're people, not unique.
No. Young people are being equipped all over the nation through release time Christian education type programs. And
now,
so it's an amazing thing.
We have a phone number and a website, and I want to put that up there and just leave it. And if you're a parent or a grandparent or if you're a taxpayer, you have a right to know about mm-hmm. this. And you can call the number. If your child is of that age, you can enroll them. Mm-hmm. It does not cost you any money.
That's right.
This is provided for our children.
Exactly. And the middle school students, they go to the classes one day a week. And it's during a related arts period.
All right.
And they have related arts periods at least twice a day, every day, the same ones. And
so they're not missing something.
No. And they make up any word that they miss. And with related arts, and related arts classes are very important. I went to school to become a teacher, and I love the related arts classes. But one day a week, it's not going to hurt their education, and they make up any work that they miss.
And the high school young people get credit.
That's right.
For attending this.
Exactly. And they go 5 days a week.
So it is a credit course for high school.
And, you know, I am just so grateful to our Greenville County School District who accommodates release time Christian education for people here in our community. And when we first started out, it was just middle school students. But in 2006, then-Governor Mark Sanford signed a bill called the Release Time Credit Act that afforded us a chance to be able to offer high school programs to students. And so they're able to go every day. We become their elective class.
Okay, now who teaches? How do you find people to present these programs?
We have to pray because our high school teacher has to be certified at the high school level.
All right.
That teacher has to work for us, cannot be working for the district, and be willing to and able to share the word of God with young people, and be willing to be there and to help them to develop spiritually. So we find them through prayer. God brings alongside of us people who are able to do that. We serve 4 high schools right now, and we serve and right now in the middle school programs, there's a release time program in 15 of the 18 middle school programs. So God is doing amazing
work.
So
this is growing.
This is growing. 15 of the 18 middle schools, and there are 6.
How long are these classes, Janet?
They're
released from their school to attend this event, mm-hmm. and how long do the classes last?
For the middle schools, it's about 50 minutes, and we try to take them no longer than a 4-minute drive away from the school.
So that we can to be close by.
Right, so that we can redeem the time. We want to teach them as long as we can. And then for the high school students, most of our high school programs are 90-minute blocks.
Okay.
We can teach a lot in 90 minutes, you know. And so we're just blessed to be able to have these opportunities. And I'm very appreciative for all the parents who have had confidence in us and was willing to sign their young people up to be a part of our Bible classes. And where would Christian Learning Centers of Greenville County be if it were not for great leaders in our community who serve on our board? We have more than 274 volunteers who work with us, who help teach the children, drive buses, ride on buses,
That's
serve
horrible.
Snacks.
Do you need volunteers?
All the time. We want as many people in the community to be involved in bringing these young people to Christ through our organization as possible. We have some volunteer positions, but if someone comes to us and say, you know, I have a burden on my heart and I really want to use my gift to help y'all in what you're doing, we're going to find a place for that person. So we're always needing volunteers. CDL drivers, that's been our challenge this year, trying to find CDL drivers. It's gotten to the point we were having to close down some classes.
Well, now, do you use the buses, school
yes,
buses?
Yes, we use, but no, not the school buses. But
heaven knows you can't get near the school.
Can't
talk
use
about.
Their buses. But we have 3 buses, 2 of them donated to us. And last year at our annual event, all those wonderful people came to our annual event, helped us buy a new used bus, 80 passenger bus, because last year there were about 5 classes that over 500 students missed. And so we don't want that to ever happen again. So, and then CDL drivers, like I was saying, they seem to be hard to find. So anybody who has a CDL license, please call us. There may be a time that we can use you for that. But we have a lot of volunteers that are already working with us.
You get donations from various churches of various denominations.
Yes.
You also get individuals making donations.
Yes, we always
do. Because you're a nonprofit,
we
right?
are a nonprofit, and so we depend, we pray to God. We know He's opened these doors, but we also know that He has the money out there that was needed to keep this program thriving. And so we ask the community to keep supporting us. Those of you who've been wonderful friends for us and everything, keep supporting this amazing ministry, because what you're doing is bringing young people to the foot of the cross, and they're able to see God at work in their lives and see God at work in our lives. So please continue that. And for those of you who have not served us in this way, please make sure to pray about where your heart is, where God wants you to serve. And if He wants you to serve through us, please call us, and we'll be glad to make you a part of our ministry. And we want to keep this going so that young people can, as many young people as possible, can be in the Word of God.
Well, I think it's very difficult to be a young person today, because they are bombarded with I mean, the motion pictures, the theaters, it's all violence and sex. And you turn on TV, and there's a lot of it on there. And this is what our young people, it becomes, after a while, you're numb to it.
That's
because
right.
You see it all the time. But I wanted to ask you, Janice, this is beautiful. If someone were to call that number, could they get one of these brochures?
Yes, of course.
This will explain exactly what Janice has tried to tell us today. And it's a wonderful brochure. And if you wanted to know more, that would be one way to get involved, or at least to be aware. And if you have children who are not involved in something like this, wherever you are, check it out, because there are people just like Janice who are bringing this, thank God, to
Yeah, we wish that every public school student was enrolled in our program. Now, I know, I don't know how we would accommodate all that, but that's God's job, right?
That's right.
But we wish that every middle school, every public school student was enrolled in this program. So if parents want to make sure that their children are in a positive peer group type situation, this is
that
the place to
so
put
much.
It. If they want right. their children with godly role models, this is the place to put right. them.
We wanted to bring you this information, and Janice Butler, you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so much.
And I'll have that information here if you did not get it and you wish to. But follow through and get one of these brochures and know what's going on, the good things that are out there for our kids. We'll be right back.